Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. How important is a dad's role in the behaviour of Pacific children? Well, a lot, it appears. A new study says a lack of parenting by Pasifika fathers leads to significantly higher behavioural problems in their children. A staggering 30% of the kids had behavioural problems because their dads were not involved in their parenting. Sena Folavasanele Chadwick explains.
These kids want the best shot at life. And now new studies show the relationship between a father and child could deliver that winning combination.
The key finding was just that those fathers that were more heavily involved with their kids tended to have children who had less problems in terms of their behaviour.
Auckland University of Technology researcher Dr. Al-Shadan Tautolos published an article looking at the effects a father's involvement has on their child.
They looked at whether they were supportive of the mum in terms of raising the kids, providing things, whether financially or otherwise, being involved with their school and education, knowing who their peers were, who their friends were, and those kinds of things, and then also encouraging them in terms of their future aspirations and goals.
The mothers were interviewed when the child was 6 weeks old, and the fathers were interviewed when the child reached age six. 571 Pacific fathers participated in the survey, which found more than 30% of children exhibited clinical or borderline behavioural issues because of fathers not being involved.
You're getting one step closer to your dream.
Aotearoa's Crosspower Ministries youth worker Tulls seen firsthand the struggle Pacific youth face when fathers aren't around.
These young men that are getting up to a lot of mischief, a lot of them, when you start breaking down the walls and actually start getting to the deep issues that they're going through, a lot of them just, you know, really wish that their dad was around.
And with New Zealand's Pacific population expected to reach 10% within the next 10 years, Tautolo says research like this will help push agendas for more parental support.
A lot of Pacific fathers spend a lot of time working, you know, and so there's that constant clash between being able to spend time with their kids but also having to provide for them as well. And that's why evidence like this could advocate for more things like more paid parental leave, flexible working hours, which might help them and support them to be more engaged and involved.
Joining me today is Nick Tuitasi, Pacific Engagement Advisor to Te Wananga O Aotearoa, who also delivers the Pasifika Parenting Program for The Parenting Place. Thanks for joining us, Nick. Mm-hmm. Well, up to 30% of kids whose parents aren't involved have behavioural problems. That's a big number, isn't it?
Yeah, but it doesn't surprise me. I think, firstly, I'd like to commend Dr. Tolo for his choosing a topic that really does help us develop from. It's a gutsy topic, and I think he's going to highlight a lot of stuff that people already knew, but now we've got the stats, which is awesome. I can just qualify it by telling a quick story. There was a church group that was going and doing prison ministry. Went into a prison. It was nearing Mother's Day, and a whole lot of prisoners asked for Mother's Day cards. Caught them by surprise, so they took them all in there, all the cards. They gave away, they didn't have enough.
Wow.
Then what happened was the church group thought, well, Father's Day's coming up, let's get some cards. Two prisoners asked for Father's Day cards. That speaks volumes that, you know, most people that end up in prison have got a very, it's a non-existent relationship with their dad, or they basically just want to kill them, one or the other.
What about for parents who, you know, for fathers who are with their families, they're trying their best, or maybe they're not as involved in parenting? Perhaps they're working two jobs, or they're 15-hour days as you go home, your son's asleep, you know?
There are a lot of good dads like that. I mean, in fact, that was my dad, too, growing up. He was working, you know, two jobs, and I hardly ever saw him. In fact, even when my daughters were saying, you know, what was granddad like as a father? I didn't really get to get intimate with him until he retired.
Wow.
And then we had some really good time. But, you know, there's fathers out there who understand it's important to put in their lives, and there's some really good ones doing a really good job. But I think the key is it's not a matter of how much time you spend on it, it's the quality that you have with them. I've seen, when we deliver the Pacifica Parenting Program, my wife shares a story which always brings a tear to my eye when I hear it, about a father who took his kid to McDonald's, sat down at the playground and read the paper, and the kid didn't go and play on the playground, just stood next to him because felt too intimidated.
Wow.
Stood the whole time my wife was watching, then folded up the paper, grabbed the kid's hand and walked out again.
So how much of that is a problem that a lot of our, well, some of our Pacific parents might feel that playing with your kids, having fun with them, is not proper parenting?
And that's because every minute of the day back in the islands, you're practically doing something. Mm. And so they feel that to play with the kid, to kick a ball or something similar, is a waste of time.
Mm. Whereas, or that you should be in the disciplinarian role.
Yeah, as well. Or even doing that. And I think it's important for dads to realise that kids, they yearn for a relationship with their father, and their father has a lot to do with how they will relate to the next generation.
So what can they do? What kind of things or practical advice? If you're working like long hours at work, how can you spend time more?
I know that, well, first of all, it really boils down to our economics. We basically have to help our Pacific people get better paid jobs so that we do have the opportunity to get along to some of the programs that help build our family. So the Living the Pacifica Pairing Program for the last 3 or 4 years, you know, we're preaching to the converted.
We
constantly have people there that are thinking, oh, I wish I could have bought my husband, or I wish I could have told my auntie to come along. We do need to get our Pacific people trained, because our Pacific parents don't know what they don't know.
What about for families or for kids who have a dad who's not in the picture at all? How can we support these children or families?
Well, I think it's important for extended family to get involved at that point. And you know, even I don't know the neighbours all that well, but I do know that there's a solo mum next door, and I'll make an effort to communicate with her son if, you know, he comes over and says hello to me at the fence. Mm. It's everybody doing
looking
a little bit.
Looking out for everyone.
It's the way it was back in the islands. But unfortunately, you know, where there's a village and you can see through the walls and your whale's back home, and you can tell, you know, if someone's getting a hard deal, well, you can sort of say to them, oh, come on, that's enough. The kids learnt the lesson, and it stops. Whereas in New Zealand, where there's no, you know, people watching, sometimes we end up, you know, with abuse, and we know that 12 kids a year die at the hands of their guardian.
Nick, thanks for coming this morning. We appreciate your time. If you've got some feedback, we'd love to hear from you as well on Facebook or Twitter.